I am Zeinder, and this is Space Engineers. And I might have gone a little bit overboard and done quite a bit off camera, but looks pretty good. I've got a blast door set up over here. This is using blast door blocks, and I believe the artificial mass is part of the small ships blocks, small ship mod pack I have in. It doesn't show everything, I don't think, but meh. I have an antenna on here, although that's just for basically insurance purposes. Did I add in the maglock mod? I think I forgot to activate it. Pretty sure this is... Yeah, I did. Landing gear is buggy, but I want to test something. There's a few things I want to test before we try and fly the ship around. Oh, right, I was going to show you the blast door. These are actually blast door blocks that are part of the base thing. There's some up here and some down here because you need to make sure they don't connect. And as you can tell, they're not a full block wide. That's how they work. I have two pistons here, and you have to make sure you weld the top of the piston. Well, I suppose in this case you probably don't, but I set up a button panel here. If I open this up, you can see down here in the toolbar, it has the option of a group I made called door pistons. And activating this with T shuts the door, although I don't like that little shift it does. But I want to test some things. And in the list of things I want to test, it has to do with rocket launchers and their effectiveness. Now, one thing I want to make sure that I test with this, I want to go with the missile turret because I should be able to directly control that. I'm also going to want 4 missiles, should be good enough. And then I'm going to want some bulletproof glass, so we'll go with, I'll just make it spit me out a bunch of them. Where is the largest size? Weird. I know there's a larger size than these. Weird. What? Is it because you're missing uranium? It's probably because you're missing uranium. Yeah. There. Stupid gravity components. I thought I told to make 4 missiles. Where's the rest of the missiles? 1, 2, 3. Okay, so on the list of things I wish to do. Where's a good place to do this? Probably over here, where I also don't put much of a risk. Now, I'm probably gonna blow the living shit out of this landing gear. But that's alright. Oh, I'm going to need steel plates. Production. Let's do 10 of these. That'll get us 1,500 plates. That should get us going pretty well. So, I want to test the blast resistance of a few different blocks. Actually, I think there's still... Oh, there's some plates in there. I want to test the blast resistance to missiles of some blocks, and so that requires multiple things. First of all, it requires a missile turret. It should be functional. What are you doing? As long as it doesn't start shooting at anything, we'll be fine. Actually, I want to... missile turret, radius... I want you to... everything to be off, because I want to manually control you. And I don't want you doing anything stupid. What? Did I not take those steel plates out? Anyhow... first, I'm gonna put these in here. I need to weld this up because, like I said, I want to test out some blast resistance of blocks. I want to see what, for example, one singular missile will do to heavy armor blocks. Now, I'm probably gonna lose the foot, but. That's bound to happen. I'm not really too concerned about losing that. I'm not even too concerned about losing the corner of this platform. Okay. So what I'm gonna wanna do... So I'll get in here, and I want to set up... Where is he? Control. Okay. What? Did I just vaporize it? Things have not quite occurred as they were supposed to. Pretty much the plan of what I'm doing here is I want to make sure I know just how strong my ship is. I need to know if it's going to be strong enough to withstand a rocket, because if it isn't, that kind of slightly, you know, removes the whole point of it. Okay. well here. But in theory, I should possibly be able to avoid the rockets, but I want to know what kind of damage the ship will receive if I do take a hit. Stupid commercial freighter. Pretty sure it has missiles on it, so I don't really want to screw with it. Well, faster. Trying to not touch it, because if I bump it, that's what's going to set it into a pre-roll. Because, as you can tell, landing gear is not fixed. I mean, I could log out and log back in, but I was kind of hoping that the maglock stuff was in, because it should, I think it should let me, it's a modded landing gear. It should have basically like been a flat surface almost, so I could hook it to the floor and not even really look like anything. But I'm gonna shoot this, and it's roughly 3 layers thick. Okay, it looks like I nailed it pretty good. So what kind of damage should I do? Looks like the outer layer was destroyed with a little bit of damage done to some surrounding blocks. Well, no, it's mostly intact, actually. The question is if it takes another shot, because I should have one more rocket available. How will it fare? Looks like I blew the landing gear to smithereens, but other than that, it survived pretty well. So, that said, I want to get 2 decoys going. Small ship. Plan here is that I'm going to put some decoys on the side here. I think I'm gonna mount it in by with a couple of. Actually, I want this farther up the side. I'm gonna do some 2x2s. The biggest question is how far out do I want these to go? I'm going to actually make a proper like weapon testing room whenever I finally get around to making a station. But I really want to try and make a functional assault ship. But having the 2 separate bars on this, or I'm calling them bars, but the connectors to connect the to where the decoy is going to be, they're going to ensure that it's a lot harder to not only shoot off the decoys, but they'll also function as a sort of protection. but as I, if you remember, I said I put the antenna on there as insurance. It's very short range, but it's there so if I screw up, I can open up the door and not have to cut through. Okay, I think I'm gonna weld that. I wanna mirror this on the other side, that's why I made two decoys. As far as I've been able to tell, if you have two decoys on the same vessel, it kind of screws up the targeting, and a lot of the times it won't really be able to shoot you. Also, I apologize if my voice is quieter than the sound effects. I noticed that it seemed like that was the case when I was looking at the videos, and I haven't made any attempt to fix it. Although the game itself is kind of loud. So I'll do that. I don't necessarily want these to be black. I actually kind of want them to be the camo color there. But I had considered attaching merge blocks on here and hooking these onto a merge block. So if I feel like I'm taking too much fire, what I can do is I can actually demerge them and move away. But like I said, I plan to make a proper like weapon testing platform and stuff like that inside of my planned station, along with a greatly increased in size grinder array. And I had some other ideas for that, but you know, obviously I don't have enough time to do everything in one episode. I think what I might do, if my internet is working, once I finally get around to making the mining ship to clear out the inside of that asteroid, where I want to build my my base, I will try to like live stream working on that, and then you guys can, you know, come in and talk to me and whatnot. However, I'm going to pre-announce that, and I may or may not do it to Twitch, or I might try to do a YouTube stream, although I've never done that, and I don't know how well it'll work. But the YouTube stream is, it's nice, because what happens is then everything that's typed into the chat ends up as comments, sort of, if that makes any sense. But if I really cared, I could overlay the chat onto the stream, and then still upload it to YouTube from there. I don't know. If you guys want, you can go ahead and give me some opinions on that. I'm just hoping that my internet decides to be stable enough to stream one of these days. Taking long enough to weld? Holy crap. Must be reaching one of the, like, far, far areas that still need to be welded. Okay, I've had enough. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the decoy here. Okay, yeah. And then there's gonna be another layer of two on the outside. A majority of the damage done to a decoy is going to come from the front, which is why I'm not putting a lot of emphasis on guarding the bottom, and well, what it's getting on the back is more or less just because. But the hope here is that this should be able to take enough hits, and especially like rocket hits, where I'll be basically unaffected. The only downside is that welding takes a little while. Should make a better welding ship, but... meh. Placing blocks around the welder. So, how am I doing on steel plates in here? I may not actually need to make the other side, making the other side's more of a precautionary measure. But, you know how it is. Better safe than sorry. Although I'm going to need more steel plates in order to pull that off effectively. Because these outer little bits here aren't really intended to take much in the way of hits, I don't have really any plans to basically make them look good, like I kind of did with the rest of the ship. Okay. So, for something to talk about, there may be wonders as to why I hadn't uploaded in so long, and it's because for a little while, I was actually working at Dollar General, and I'm going to put this out here. I do not recommend working in retail, at least not, well, cheapo stores. That's the only way I can describe it. They are literally stores that sacrifice everything in order to make a cheaper price. So, yeah. Plus, to make matters worse, what? Did I not? Is there not, like, enough upward thrust to really move this? Oh no, there's something just really weird going on with, the game. Like, I don't know what it is, but I'm pressing Q right now and nothing's happening, but the moment I start moving the camera and telling it to rotate, everything becomes a bit more solid, if that makes any sense. Like, the responsiveness of everything is a bit screwed up right now. This latest patch has really been a bit iffy. But, what can you do? Well, these... what am I doing on plates? I'm down to 70. Weld faster. Kind of disappointed at how, like, buggy this patch has been, because, I mean, okay, fine. I, you know, I'm gonna let it off because of the fact it's an alpha, but I don't understand how you break things that are working just fine. I mean, okay. You'd think that, you know, oh, I should be used to that, having, you know, been somebody who's played ABB. They managed to break core, you know, they managed to completely break things, and it doesn't even make sense. We have added a new contact, And for some odd reason, that contact crashes the district it's in by sheerly existing. I don't understand how placing one singular NPC that sits still and you can talk to, that has been done probably 40 other times, at least, in the game, and have it destroy everything. If that makes any sense. That looks pretty decent. What is the distance away? This one, two, three, four. So, 5. Like that. Starting 2 down from the top. I believe this is 6. Yeah. I was originally kind of thinking about not doing this, but there's no ships to fly after in this right now. Now, something else I've been debating, do I want to put weapons on this? Because obviously, whether or not I want to put weapons is going to be a questionable experience. Because, like, especially if I go after the military mine layer, it can be very bad to have weapons positioned on this. If that makes any sense. Because, just think about it for a second. It's a mine layer. It's filled with warheads. Firing a rocket at it means I could potentially blow up everything. And don't get me wrong, blowing up the ship would be really interesting. And fun. But that's not really what I'm currently looking to do. And also, I want 10 more. I'm not going to have enough to weld this side. That much I know for sure. Ah, there's a military escort now. You know what? There's nothing important enough out of the unbuilt spots that I'm really worried about. Let's get in here. We'll close the blast door. And I'm going to press Y to enable the batteries. I say batteries because there's 2 batteries on here now. Turn off the inertial dampeners. Why is there banging? Trust that. Okay, I don't trust pistons, extended pistons. Right now, my biggest concern, I'm gonna turn the auto lock back on because the goal is to get up to the ship and lock onto it. Okay, let's stop the ship, realign myself, and it's go time. So, obviously the ship is extremely heavy. Oops. Well, that's extremely hard to see through. Okay. We need you to practically stop. Go. The ship is not very maneuverable, and it's making it very hard to get anywhere near this military escort. But that's what happens when you build an entire small ship out of heavy armor. So pretty soon here, it should start firing upon me. Why is it not shooting the decoy? Excuse me. Decoy? Decoy? How's the ship faring? They've knocked out two glass panels, dented that pretty good, still have all my landing gear. Running into the issue of the ship is just too heavy to really do what I'm trying to do. That, and there's so many glitches with stuff not working. Yeah. The unfortunate thing is the current state of the game is very glitchy. So, I think because of how many things are glitchy, I mean, obviously the decoy wasn't working, the landing gear really buggy, gyroscope, I mean, it was being really buggy. As you can see, I had to actually move my camera around in order to force it to start working. So, what I think I'm going to do is I'm probably going to make a mining ship. Now, this has gone on long enough that we're actually over again, but the ship is gone. Like, I gave up on that small ship. Yeah, it took time to build, and it got destroyed almost instantly, but that's part of the reason why I plan on doing, like, you know, weapons testing, if that makes any sense. It's why I'm going to build up, like, a missile launcher and a Gatling gun. I'm going to make a little test room to shoot at stuff with them. So, I think what I want to do is I'm going to make the mining ship, and I'm going to dig out that. We'll work on the mining ship next episode, though, because we really need to wrap up here. So, unfortunately, I'm going to have to wait for a bug fix for quite a few things, probably, before we can go after any, like, properly armed ships. I can still have to go after, like, business shipments and stuff, but I'm gonna have a metric ton of resources, I'm sure, once I go through there, so I'm gonna call this good, and I will see you guys next time. Have a good day.